Okay, guys, M13 here, and I'm talking about a totally free game that you can download, and it truly is free. And I have spoke with the makers of the game, and they said they work hard at making sure that the people that play it for free and the people that spend some money on it, buying in-game money, which you can do, of course, they have to make the money somehow, have an even playing field. And it's really true, because I've played it, and I see how what they're doing. I've actually spent a good amount of money buying in-game money, but it gives me no if you spend money on the game, it gives you more choices of what you can do. It doesn't give you an advantage. I'll explain it in more detail. Anyway, so League of Legends, that's the name of the game, League of Legends. There's a link in the description of this video. You can use that link to sign up, because it gives me like a referral bonus if you play the game. And you know, I get some kind of like in-game bonus. It's not a big deal, but nonetheless, if you get like 1,000 people to sign up through, you get some kind of huge prize. But I highly doubt I'll get that many. Let me go. What am I talking about? What's with the traffic, eh? So League of Legends, it's a totally free game. I downloaded it, it's hard to play in it, and I love it. It's an RTS, so it's kind of a top-down click-click, move characters around, right-click to move here, left-click to select power or whatnot. But you only control, the way it's different from most RTSs is you only control one unit. It's kind of like a super unit. And that's what she said. This word units is going to get me in trouble. So, I want to get away from this traffic, man. I don't want to be in, like, bumper to bumper for the whole video. Can I cut here? Yeah, I can. Sure, why not? So, I'm like hanging off, knee touching the ground. So the game is a top-down strategy, but you only control one unit. Only controlling one unit is such a, it's you know, people think, oh, that's less strategy. It's a lot of strategy, because you really, it's just more focused. Instead of controlling 100 units and just jumping around the screen constantly, you get to focus on one area, but there's still a large amount of strategy that's involved. And if you don't believe me, just watch what happens when a noob goes up against some guys who've been playing the game for a few months. They just get totaled. They get just decimated every time. And then you're like, well, if it's just one guy versus one guy, then it's just be bang, 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 bang. One guy wins, one guy loses. And it's no, there's a lot of strategy involved. Inside the game, when you're playing the game, as you kill characters, you gain gold, and then there's stores in-game that you can buy, and you can use the stores to upgrade different aspects of your abilities, and the what you buy can totally shape your character. Like there are characters in the game that are kind of just balanced, like their skills and abilities are balanced. So it all depends on what you buy while playing to see what kind of character you make. You know, like you could have both teams could have the same character. Both teams could have the same character, and then on one team that character could be like hardcore mage, sorcerer, spellcaster, just low hit points, not much physical damage, but high spell damage. And then the same guy on the other team could be pure warrior. His spells don't do much damage, and because it's all about what the items that they bought and how they upgraded their characters. So it makes it really unique. And there's a lot of strategy involved in what you buy. And then if you just kind of bought, you know, mixed items, then your character wouldn't really specialize in any one area, and then you wouldn't be doing high damage with spells, and you wouldn't be doing high damage with your sword, so you'd just kind of be doing medium damage, but, you know, so you need to kind of know what you're doing as you're buying them. And then not only that, I'm not even advanced enough to do this yet, but there's a lot of people in the game, they'll look at what characters they're fighting against on the opposite team, and then they'll buy their items according to how best to fight against those specific characters. So like, you know, and I don't do that. I just buy what I think is good for my guy, and I understand enough to know what I'm buying and how it'll affect him. But I'm not so advanced that I can look at the other team and figure out what I should be buying to counter their characters. think it's pretty interesting. There's a little town here, and I've done this road on a lot of my videos, this road that I was just doing, but I don't think I've ever really done this little town, so let's go check it out. Check it out.